Welcome to this new Inside Code video where we will see how to shuffle an array. So we are given an array R and you're asked to create a function that shuffles it, in other words that rearranges its elements randomly. Know that you can use randomness related functions, for example the one that generates a random number between A and B. Okay, now pause the video and try to think of a way to do so. If you were asked to shuffle a sequence of elements in real life, I think that the most intuitive way to do it is to keep randomly choosing an element from the remaining ones and put it on the shuffled sequence. For example, with this sequence, we can choose let's say 5, we take it to our shuffled sequence, then 2, then 7, then 1, then 4, then 3, then 6, and we got the initial sequence shuffled. Note that I randomly chose the values. This method works and can easily be translated to code because we just need to create an array called shuffled, then while we still have elements in R, we randomly generate the index of the next element that we're gonna take, we add it to our shuffled sequence and we remove it from R. After getting the shuffled sequence, we assign it to R because now R is empty. For the time complexity, we know that popping an element from an array runs on O(f) and time complexity because we need to move all elements after it to the left, and we are repeating this operation n times, where n is the number of elements in R, so the time complexity is O(f) n squared. And for the space complexity, we need extra space for the shuffled array, so it's O(f) n. This algorithm is the old version of the Fisher-Yates algorithm. Why is it the old version? Because the algorithm appeared in 1938, so it wasn't really made for computers. But when it comes to computers, the algorithm is not that efficient because of its quadratic time complexity. This is why the new version of the Fisher-Yates algorithm runs on linear time complexity, we will see it later. Now let's move on to the second possible solution. This one is less intuitive than the first one, but still works. The idea of the second solution is that we assign a random number between 0 and 1 for each index in the array, then we just sort them according to their random value and we get the array shuffled. You can see that random values are sorted. While explaining the code, I want to show you what really happens in the process because I'll use some list comprehension so it's possible to get confused if you're not familiar with Python. We want to shuffle this array that has n elements, so we first generate an array of n random values between 0 and 1. Next step, we create an array that contains n indexes, then we sort them according to their random value. Here we got this result because the smallest random value is at index 3, then 1, then 6, and so on. Now that we got indexes of the shuffled sequence, we just replace each index with the element at that index in R, and we got the result. The time complexity of this solution depends on the sorting algorithm used. If we use merge sort or quick sort, for example, we get an O(f) n log n time complexity. And for the space complexity, we are using extra space for rand values and rand indexes, so it's O(f) n. It's time to move to the third solution, which is, as said earlier, the new version of the Fisher-Yates algorithm, and you will see that we just need to do a slight change to get a linear time solution. But before, please take some seconds to like the video and to subscribe to the channel, if you want to do so obviously. What was slowing down our first solution is popping the element from the array, so the idea is that instead of having two separate arrays and always popping from the first one, we will do everything on the same array. We will kinda split R into two parts, the left part represents elements that didn't get shuffled yet, and the right part is the shuffled sequence. You'll better understand with an example, we have this array and we want to shuffle it. You can now see the line that separates the two parts, and we didn't start shuffling yet, so it's in the rightmost position. You have to know that during this process we will use a pointer called lastIndex that indicates the index of the last element of the left part. Now, we choose a random element between 0 and lastIndex. Let's choose 3 for example. Here, we want to take 3 to the shuffled part and remove it from the unshuffled one. So what we can do is to swap 3 with the element at lastIndex, which is 7, because by doing so, we took 3 to the shuffled part and we avoided losing the value 7. Last step of the iteration, we decrement lastIndex because now the lastIndex of the left part is the 6th index. We repeat, we choose 5 for example, we swap with lastIndex and we decrement. Another iteration, we choose 1 for example, we swap with lastIndex and we decrement. We still have elements in left part so we continue, we choose 6 for example, we swap with lastIndex and we decrement. We repeat, choose, swap, decrement. Again, choose, swap, decrement. Here lastIndex became 0 so we have no more elements to shuffle, we finished shuffling R as you can see. In code, we create lastIndex, then while lastIndex is still above 0, we generate a random index between 0 and lastIndex inclusive, we swap R of rand index with R of lastIndex, and we decrement lastIndex. That's it. For the time complexity of this solution, generating, swapping, and decrementing all run in O of 1, and the loop is repeated n times, so the time complexity is O of n. We got a linear time solution for shuffling an array. The space complexity also decreased, because you could notice that we didn't need extra space, we did everything in place, so the space complexity is constant, O of 1. A little recap, in this video we learned how to shuffle an array in 3 different ways. The old version of the Fisher-Yates algorithm that keeps randomly popping elements from R and putting them elsewhere, the second method where we assign a random value to each index in R then we sort them according to it, and the modern version of the Fisher-Yates algorithm where we do everything in place by separating R into a shuffled and unshuffled part. Before ending this video, let me tell you that if you like this style of videos where I solve a problem in one or different solutions while comparing their time and space complexities, then you can get 50 of them by taking the 50 popular coding interview problems inside Code course. You can find the link in the description. I hope that you enjoyed this video, please comment below what you thought about it, and see you in the next one.